today we are going to show you how to shade with pencil. The materials required for our tutorial is just any sketch paper you have, any sketch paper which has either a multimedia paper or just from a sketch pad, two kinds of pencils, even one is fine if you have one. This one is a thicker one and this one is a thinner one, and an eraser, and if you need some, just some color pencils. So there are different kinds of shading techniques, and when you add light and shadow to your line drawings, you can make your subject come to life. In order to shade better, you will need to practice three things: pressure control, how to shade smoothly, and most importantly, understand how light behaves. I'm going to walk you through all these three things and then we'll shade something together. So the first one is different shading techniques. As you can see, I have cross hatching here. This is a smooth shading, random patterns, but they all go in the shape of the object, bearing in mind where the light is coming from. So we're going to start with this apple. So see how the sun is shining on the apple over here, and all this part is light and this is dark. So let's start with, let's say there is a sun here coming out from the corner. That's my left hand corner. And then you just draw a light line like that coming down. And where shall I make the apple sit? Right here. Yeah, so I'm going to draw the apple, shape of the apple, like an oval, mostly like a heart shape. You get so many different kinds of apples, right? And I'll put a little branch here. I try and draw very lightly, so I wonder if you can see my drawing. Yeah, very light. You can always darken it. There's my apple. So bear in mind that if the sun is coming from here, let's color this yellow so it's easier to see. I'm going to take my thick pencil, this one, and I'm going to go around the, in a round shape like that. Try and hold the pencil sideways like that. And go in a circular motion like that. And it's, since it's sitting here and the light is coming from there, this part is going to be really dark. So let's make it a little dark here. More darker here. And then now I can go in there and then I can darken all my lines. Try to make it more rounder over here. And darker on the right hand side. That's where the light is not hitting, and you can make it a little rounder from here too. And there's your apple. I'd like to add some nice color in there to make it more interesting. Same way, try and hold the pencil sideways, and there you go. Apple is done. And then I would add a little bit of yellow here and blend it in. Make the branch, the stem a little bigger, more visible. And there, There you are, the apple is ready. Don't you feel like taking a bite of it? And that's the one I have made already. It's nice and colorful. And that's our apple. So dark at the bottom here. And in a round motion like that, so it maintains this the shape of the apple. The next one I'm going to show you is the leaves with the branches. And I thought, since it's spring, let's do some spring looking leaves and branches. So I'm going to show you how I've shaded all these dark parts and then the lighter shades. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab a new paper and your thin pencil, and we're just going to draw some leaves. So the leaves are any leaves you like, any shapes you like, just some random shapes like that. It's like a vine going up and down, joining each other here. Like that. Make sure you have a line in between. And put one here. Bring that down. Put another one over here. You can add as many leaves as you want. Try and make your branches a little thicker. So I'll show you how we can shade those. So again, we are going into our thick pencil. And we're going to start from the top. So I'm going to shade sideways like this. It's going to be sideways. A little more pressure. So and again, I would shade the other side of this leaf. But go in a slanting position like that. This one over here, again. And this one. You can always erase the shapes if you're going out of line or if it's going outside the, you know, drawing of your drawing. It's okay. It's your drawing. You can do whatever you like. Whichever way you want to draw your leaves, you're welcome to draw. Right. Now this one. I'm going to make this. Shade like that, and this one, you may lose some shapes, but that's fine. One more here. There's one more over here, a tiny little one is hiding in the corner. Yeah. And there. Try and go sideways. Now for the branches. Suppose this is a branch here. We can do cross hatching, which is like cross, crisscross, crisscross like that on the edge. So it gives a more fuller look to the branch. It gives, you can even do something like this. See this? Something like that. You can make it darker, lighter. So the whole idea is to give a rounder shape to the branches. That. Now for the other side, I'm going to take the thin pencil. I'm going to give less pressure and I'm going to just shade the other side of the leaf. So shading is all about pressure. How much pressure you give to your drawing. If you give light pressure, you get light pencil marks. If you do like a hard one, you get darker. If you give more pressure, you get darker. Oh, there you go. And we are almost done. Then you can color your, get your shades in the branches. If you would like to give a little bit of color in there, most welcome to do so. Otherwise, you can just leave it black and white, and that looks great too. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.